Yo, 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 CPA Strength here, back again. Oh, my best prepaid insurance video ever. Strongest in the game. Let's just get into this, okay? This is Accounting for Beginners, number 121 of my classic series. I have the whole classic series in a playlist over here. Check it out, it's helped thousands of people. Like, comment with your question. This is a viewer question. So comment with a question. Also like, I will send a cookie in the mail. 2 business days. Prepaid, this is about prepaid insurance. You prepaid 1 year of insurance for $2,400 cash on January 1st. Prepaid insurance, $2,400, January 1st. Paid cash for it. We're gonna make an adjusting journal entry 1 month later. So let's get into this here. Let's just think about what we do. We prepaid. It might not say prepaid in the question. Sure, you're probably taking this for accounting class. It might not say prepaid in the question. So you gotta think, we're getting an insurance policy. Now just, you know, it can be very overwhelming. I get overwhelmed by a bunch of thoughts too about various things. You gotta just, let's just slow down, namaste, and think about what went on. You had an outlay of $2,400. Did we, for what? For insurance. Okay, have we used the insurance yet? No, the policy's starting January 1st, and it's gonna run through the whole year. So we got a $2,400 policy for the whole year. So we're prepaying, we haven't used it yet, we're paying, and we're prepaying. So that's an asset. An asset is something that provides a future economic benefit to our business. Let's go over this real quick. Also, this is DCAdler. This is why I have at this moment 75,000 subscribers, because of DCAdler. If you don't know about it, watch some of the other videos. It really will help. Debit, credit, asset, draw, expense, liability, equity, revenue. Now let's do the January 1st journal entry. This is going to record the prepaid insurance. What do we have? Like I always say, if you're doing journal entries, if you're working on stuff, always know what cash does, because most journal entries, most things will have cash involved in it. If your cash is an asset, if cash is increasing, debit. If asset draw expense are increasing, you debit it. Cash is an asset. It is leaving because you're paying $2,400. So it's leaving your bank. So that would be, so cash is an asset, cash is leaving. So that's gonna be your credit. $2,400 cash is your credit. Slow down. Why is this cash leaving your bank account? What is the purpose of it? To get insurance. I'm gonna have insurance for my business for the next 12 months, but you haven't used any of it up yet. So that would be a prepaid insurance. And if you prepay, you know, it's got economic benefit for the future. So that's a prepaid is an asset as well. You know, you have something, you haven't used it yet. Maybe I just thought of this, maybe think of it as like a inventory or something, right? Like you have it in your business and you're gonna use it for later. It's kind of like a prepaid insurance. So that's an asset. We didn't have any prepaid insurance on our books. Now the account's gonna go up by $2,400. If an asset's going up, you debit it. That's gonna be our journal entry on January 1st. 1 month later, now we're gonna make an adjusting entry. It's adjusting because there's really no transaction happening, no cash happening. It's just we're adjusting to make everything copacetic, because now we've used a month of the insurance. So now we're gonna make an adjusting entry for the prepaid insurance, for our insurance. We can look at it with this one of two ways here. So first let's go over here. 2,400 divided by 12 is $200 a month. On January 31st, I know this isn't exactly a month later. You make your adjusting entries on the end of the month. You know, typically you're gonna do your tax return, you're gonna do your balance sheet. You're gonna do your tax return, and it's gonna run from January 1st to December 31st. So if you do your adjusting entries on, say, the first of the month, and you're not gonna have it done by December 31st. So we're just gonna have this January 31st, it's a full month. $200 a month. is what we've noted that we're paying for insurance. So insurance, we need it to keep our business going, to stay safe, stay away from them claims. So we're gonna have expense, if expense is going up, and mostly all expenses are gonna be going up in your general journal. So mostly every expense is gonna be a debit. We have $200 insurance expense. Cause now we've gone a month and used it for a month. So now we have insurance expenses, the debit. And that's an expense, so it goes up, right. You're like, I don't know. So you have DCA written out. You know you've gone a month, it's $200. And now you need to adjust on your prepaid accounts because now you've used a month up. And you know, okay, insurance, I've used insurance for a month. Insurance is an expense. So you got debit, $200 insurance expense. Now how's that gonna balance? How's that gonna equal on the credit side? How are we gonna equal that out? Well, let's think, you know you prepaid $2,400, you've used a month of it up, so you've used $200 up of it. Do you still have in your account, in your prepaid insurance asset account, $2,400? Is that how much you've prepaid now? No, because you've used a month up, so you've prepaid 11 months, so you have $200 less in your prepaid account, because you've got a month and we've noted that a month is $200. So how would we lessen prepaid insurance is an asset. If we want to lessen an asset, what would we debit or credit it? Let's see, let's go to our DCAdler. We have, if we're increasing an asset, we debit it. But no, we want to decrease the asset, so we're crediting it. So we're gonna credit prepaid insurance because we're decreasing it. And that's gonna be the journal entry. So let's proof this out here. Let's just proof this out and see if it's all copacetic here. $2,400 in our prepaid insurance account. That was from this journal entry, and we had a year. $2,400 divided by 12 is $200 a month. So now one month later, we've credited the prepaid insurance. So we're gonna negative $200 of prepaid insurance. So now we have $2,200 in our prepaid insurance account. Does that make sense? Does that look right? Yeah, because now we have 11 months left at $200 a month, $2,200. So that checks out. What about on our balance sheet for our two? A balance sheet for our two, because everything balances, right? Assets equal liabilities plus equity. Assets equal liability plus equity, which is also on our DCAdler. Does this balance out? Look, for our first journal entry, you have an asset going up and an asset going down. So you have an asset going up here and an asset going down. So this checks out on the balance sheet. Over here, you've got an expense going up. Now this one's a little tricky. I just did my last accounting for a beginner. I just recently did accounting for beginners, and I found I did one a long time ago too, but I forgot because I have so many. But this is a little trickier. So let's just see. You have an asset going down by $200 with the prepaid insurance because it's a credit. It's an asset credit. So you have an asset going down negative for $200 equals liabilities plus equity. Now you gotta remember, inside of equity is net income. Inside of equity is net income. Net income is revenue minus expenses. Revenue minus expenses. You've got an expense going up for $200. So an expense, $200. No revenue, zero minus 200. You're gonna have net income of negative 200 here. So yeah, it matches up on the balance sheet. So I implore you to slow down, especially in the beginning. Don't just go on, you know, different rules and that's what helped me. I didn't really understand accounting until I studied for the CPA exam and I passed the CPA exam, and that's when I had to really learn this stuff and know inside and out. I couldn't go on all these crazy rules. So I tell you, I just slowed down, figured out what was going on with everything. With every journal entry, it's going to affect the balance sheet in some way. It might affect the income statement as well. But realize after every journal entry, what it's doing to the balance sheet, the income statement. You got to understand what categories everything is. Is it an asset? Is it a withdrawal? Is it an expense? Is it a liability? Is it an equity? Is it a revenue? You know, at first, it's going to take a long time to do a journal entry. Like these two journal entries, this one problem took me, I've been going 15 minutes. And so it might take you 15, might take you half an hour. But guess what? Next time you see, if you slow down and work it, next time you could probably do this problem in half the time, in 15 minutes. Next time you see this problem, you can do it in 7 minutes. Next time, in 4 minutes, and you're just gonna keep on working it. Anyways, I love doing these. I get the most pleasure I get from when I get comments saying I'm helping people out. So until tomorrow, CPA Strength, I'm out. Deuces.